Samsung's televisions, they flicker by default. Here's why and how to avoid it. This flicker might or might not be noticeable depending on the person observing it. To me, it is a distracting sort of restlessness within the image, especially when I move my eyes around. Some people react more strongly. They might not be aware of the flicker itself, but experience eye strain or headaches or even nausea or migraine in front of a flickering display, especially in the long run when binge watching or gaming for hours. Or, probably just as common, you might not notice anything at all. This flicker is easily picked up by the camera on your mobile phone. Anyone can try this for themselves. The flicker is also exaggerated by the camera and its settings. It does not look like this in real life. The reason behind all this flickering is how the display controls the LEDs that provides a backlighting. The method used is pulse width modulation. In short, the Samsung controls the light output in pulses by modulating the LEDs on and off. The backlighting is essentially a strobe. The width terms come from how long the LEDs are turned off. The longer the period, the more obvious the flickering becomes. Therefore, the flickering is more detectable when lowering the backlight. Simply put, if the LEDs give you 1,000 nits without ever turning off, then 500 nits means they are turned off 50% of the time. 100 nits means they are turned off 90% of the time, which means more obvious flicker. The strobing on the Samsung is done in a fixed frequency of 120 Hz. This is considered a low frequency. Above 80 Hz is usually considered to be the limit where most humans will no longer notice any flicker. But like everything else related to biology and brains, this is not an absolute limit. You might be affected without actually knowing there is a flickering light source involved. Many older computer monitors use pulse width modulation. This is a solution that the industry in large has moved away from in recent years because the flickering is associated with eye strain and fatigue, especially when you spend several work hours in front of the screen. This is why you see so many computer monitors today advertised as flicker-free on the box. Other methods are used to control the light output. Not every Samsung TV behaves this way, however, most of the high-end Q series do. I have not seen them all. You can easily detect this yourself with a camera on your smartphone. The flickering is controllable to some degree. Not completely gone, but it strobes in a much higher frequency, most likely in the 1000 Hz range. And that is way more than both our visual system and our cameras usually perceive as strobing. You might even reap benefits from strobing the display or the backlighting, especially from fast-paced games. Strobing is often used as a countermeasure against smearing and ghosting, making a moving image look sharper, which points us to the solution to the flickering. To turn off the strobing, all you have to do is turn off the image interpolation. You know, the part that makes the motion much smoother. This is often called Auto Motion Plus. With Samsung 2020 models, it might be called Picture Clarity under the picture settings. And when running game mode, there's a new menu called Game Motion Plus, and it's in a different place in the system. The reason Samsung uses 120 Hz strobing with interpolation is probably because of the mentioned reasons. It's a method for making a moving image look sharper. If you turn these settings off, you will of course lose motion interpolation. And personally, I do not consider that to be a total loss, as the Samsung, at least this one does, handles standard 44p movie motion very well. This is the way movies has been produced for the last 100 years or so. This is how virtually every movie looks, frame by frame. Interpolation makes motion smoother by blending and morphing frames in various ways, often making crude guesses. This is never perfect and causes artifacts and irregular movement. Parts of the image sort of morphs in and out of existence, and sometimes whole motion patterns are skipped. Some people love this, some people can't stand it. But one thing is sure, with the Samsung you cannot have both interpolation and a flicker-free experience at the same time. Interpolation is used by default with almost all picture modes. Even game mode on several Samsung models uses interpolation by default, which causes flicker, artifacts, and also increases input lag. In fact, even PC mode strobes the backlighting at 120 Hz, and I find no way of turning it off. So use game mode instead when you're running a PC. The worst case scenario is with a dark room with a low backlight setting, because when you lower the backlight, the modulation turns off the LEDs for a longer period. You can of course decrease the flickering by increasing the backlight, making the TV brighter, but you might not want a brighter image depending on your viewing conditions. I can measure this flicker with the Klein K10A. It notices a primary flicker at 120Hz. With the backlight at full and brightest level, the relative difference is about 50%. It means that the on period of the strobing has about 50% stronger light output compared to the off period, according to the meter, that is. When lowering the backlight, the relative difference increases. The flickering also becomes more noticeable. This is picked up by the camera as well. Now, the camera will make this look way worse than it is in real life. As I said in the beginning, to my eyes, this is more of a disturbance. I'm certainly not an expert on how to measure flicker, nor am I an expert on the regulations or guidelines surrounding this issue. Formally, this is called TLA, or temporal light artefacts. What I do here is also not a precise measurement, it is just another way to show the difference. As far as I can tell, I use Google as anyone else does, there really is very little regulations on flickering. And the literature I can find is targeted towards indoor and workplace lighting, lamps and so on, not the flickering from displays. There is the one opinion from the EU based on an overview of several sources, linked down in the description. Basically, it states two things. One is that effects of flicker is not widely researched or often ignored, and flicker above 100Hz is suggested as a concern for some people. It might cause discomfort, including headaches and migraine. And again, these effects are not widely researched. The final question here is, do other brands flicker as much as the Samsung does? From my experience, they do not. Other TVs do of course flicker for similar reasons, but this can vary a lot between models, usage and settings. I have not viewed every brand or model out there with every setting possible. Also, other televisions and display technologies do flicker as well. For instance, plasmas and single-chip DLP, they flicker by design, but they flicker in a different way. This is not a Samsung problem, but a display problem in general. For the Samsung, there's an easy fix. Turn off motion interpolation, and the display will no longer flicker. And then again, you might not notice anything at all. Hopefully, you learned something new today. Thank you.